Welcome, everybody. This is your host, Lirvok, and we are just in time for more Doom. This may actually be the final episode of Doom. Actually, you know, I'm calling it, this is the finale episode. So, yeah, for the final episode of Doom, we're going to be finishing up our mission in Hell. And the first thing we're going to be doing is we're going to be using the Crucible to kill this Wraith. I believe that's what they're called. Yeah, the Wraith. There's three Wraiths that we have to kill. This is our first one. We see our fellow knights pointing us in the direction that we must go now. And before we go any further, we want to hit this skull switch because that activates one secret. I think that might actually be the one that we want to get too. Like the important, the one for the classic map. Which, this one? I think it might be. Is it? No, it's not. Okay. I believe, yeah, this will be uncovered. So there's another one we have to get. I believe, we may have to get all three switches. Oh, really? Of course they closed the door on us. We wanted to go the other way, because the other way had a giant skull we walked through. Oh, we did find a secret though, so that's good. Let me go that way, but if we go down this way, gonna we come back through here and yep, we get to go through the skull. Okay.
He must not be allowed to free them.
Okay, so I see what looks like Berserker over there, so we're gonna head over there and grab ourselves Berserk. And we're gonna go Berserker Rage on everything here. Oh, and he's already, let's get him before, there we go, that we can get armor. It's amazing the small amounts of detail you'll actually see in the situation. And we'll start ripping and tearing into everything. As they all just come straight for us, jeez. Oh, there we go. I think it would have been neat to have like a dash button. I think I may have mentioned before, but the use of like a dash button to this kind of not a run button, mind you. It's you press shift and dash you forward would be, I think, immensely helpful in these fire. There we go. It was not firing the rockets for a second. Thought my mouse was dying on me, which is weird because it shouldn't be dying on me. I paid like $60 for this mouse. Of course, I have had it for almost a year. Yeah, almost a year. So even then, I've had cheaper mice for much longer. So it shouldn't be. There we go. Just finish those guys off. And you notice we have like tons of opportunity to use BFG. These are BFG, even if you don't have the more ammo rune on. And kill them. There we go. Actually, I think the BFG might be one of the few weapons where it's like it's discouraged to do direct hits on. For the most part. I mean, unless you're fighting a boss. Because against normal enemies, a BFG, like, oh, I don't want to use that there. Can you get these guys? No, you're not screwed. Like, if I do this, it just kills everyone. And I didn't hit a single target directly. So it's like one of those weird cases where it's just better just kind of aim for, you know, in a direction, in a vague direction towards them, as long as like it crosses their, as long as they're within range, which isn't all that hard to do. Like I said, there's the use for a dash, just kind of get up to the enemy before the before run that before the. Oh wow! Okay, so we can damage ourselves that way. Gotta be careful. I know now is not the time for experimentation, but I did not realize we could actually blow it up that fast. There we go. Whew. Another thing too, if we introduced a dash to do the so we could do glory kills, it wouldn't. I don't think it would ruin the game at all. I mean, maybe if you did it as a rune, allow access to a dash as a rune to go towards glory kills. But it only works towards glory kills. Like the, instead of the get them from longer range, you just get a dash that, you know, just hit shift and it dashes you towards the nearest glory kill target that you're facing. And then like the upgrade version of it would be like slightly better range or allows you to chain dash. So you dash, kill, and then like immediately there we go. I believe that might be it. Yep. Whew. That was... Got our chance to restock here. I love how, like, they... Like, the reward system for this game is really good. You just get through with a tough fight, then you get a chance to restock so that you're on at least somewhat equal grounds. This won't refill you completely depleted, but it will get you where you need to go. So let's go ahead and activate this one. And we killed another wraith. I believe the backstory for the wraiths oh, that they were... I could look this up, but I don't want to ruin the flow of the game. But they're like, really high power, like, really high, highly powerful mages, in the Argent Denure. And when the demons invaded Argent Denure, because I believe Argent Denure was not originally a part of Hell, when the demons invaded the Argent Denure, they used the wraiths to give them near unlimited power. So they basically trapped the souls of the wraiths, and that's why they are in the condition they are now. I think I could be misremembering that, but I'm fairly certain that's what it said in the bios. If we go into, say, Argent Denure, most of the details regarding the location have been exacerbated. The hell energy that emanates from this region passes through a dimensional tear and appears on Mars. All falls before the command of hell, for our power is absolute. Our march is inevitable. Before our armies, even the elemental raids of Argent Denure were subjugated. Yeah. So that's like highly implying that, and we are not... Where would this goal be? Because that, you saw, was a door. Because I think all the hidden skulls are up here somewhere. In the wraith area. Now, it's possible, because we've already got two of them, that the third one is in the last wraith area, but... I don't know. Like I said, this is where things start getting a little hazy for me and a little more maniacal for them, because it's the last level, so it's perfect. So So, yeah, this has to lead somewhere. Ah, there we go. And I think if we go back... Yeah, now this door is... Yeah, there we go. And we completed the challenge. So what's the last challenge we have here? Kill two barons of hell with one shot. That's gonna be easy. Just use the BFG. Wow, I forgot what that was called. My brain just shut down there for a second. I am so... are you tired of me saying I'm sorry enough? It's actually kind of funny. It's kind of like a... It's funny! It's funny, speaking of the word I'm sorry. It's kind of like a forbidden word now. Anyone else notice that? Like, nobody ever says they're sorry. They just get more angry at the person for being right. I mean, it's messed up that we do that, but it's like... It's true, though. You get into an argument on the internet, it's like, no one's ever sorry, it's just, I'm angry because I know I'm right and you're wrong, even though I'm clearly wrong. It's like people have lost their ability to be polite. And it's like... It's kind of embarrassing, actually, when you stop to think about it. It kind of starts making sense how we have... Our current president, for those of you watching this in the future, it's currently the year 2017, so that should be able to tell you. Yeah, it's the dark times. that should pretty much tell you what I think about our current, America's current political leader, which apparently there are supporters for Agent Orange. President Orange Julius. I'm still trying to figure out other names because I don't want to call him by name because it's like Voldemort or Beetlejuice. You say his name three times, and I'm afraid he's gonna appear and do something awful. Which, to be fair, he's already done some pretty stupid and awful things already. Within like less than 2 months of being president, he's already pissing people off, which is really sad. It's really sad this has come down to it already. And there are people defending this guy, apparently. Which, I mean, and I guess it's inevitable, but just... Those people aren't being taken seriously, are they? Because they... Not by any speck of a chance any of those people are watching this video. Go ahead and act offended and say you're gonna unsubscribe. I don't want your subscriptions anyway. It's not worth having to compromise my own political views to please people who don't know how politics actually works. To please people who are clearly anti-supporters of the other candidate, or just, you know, racist old whatever dummies who think that a reality television host and a man who bankrupted a casino is worth being president. I mean, seriously, the guy bankrupted the casino. How do you do that? How do you bankrupt a business whose sole business is to make money? You have to try hard to bankrupt a casino. I'm just waiting for someone to come up and say, oh, actually, it's really easy to bankrupt a casino if you put it in the right area or something. Which I'm sure it is, but most of those areas, they don't allow casinos anyway, so... I mean, you made a casino, presumably you put it in a location where it's legal to have one, so... Clearly, it's not an issue of whether or not it would succeed, because it's a casino. It's a casino. How do you bankrupt a... You bankrupted a place where its chief import is money. Its only import and export is money. I guess maybe import would be importing the chips. but whatever. Whatever, it's there to make money. So, we finished up the last of the raids. I ranted off enough about President Orange Julius. And, yes, again, for the 13th time. I'm not going to say his name. One, because it's funnier just to call him Agent Orange or Orange Julius or something else with orange in it, because clearly, you know, the man's trying to compensate for some... The man's got insecurities.
They promised me so much.
But yeah, here we are getting ready for the final battle against Olivia. Oh, what the heck? Yeah, so she was betrayed and goes into the blood pit, and out comes the second most iconic boss of Doom ever, Spider Mastermind. Yeah, one of the big things they said, even in the game manual, they say the worst thing you do is attach a plasma chain gun to the Spider Mastermind. The only thing you can do to make it worse is attach a plasma gun to it. And what they do in this game, holy crap, it's giving not only a plasma gun, but it's giving sideways lancer rifle beams on the side. Look at that! Look at that! They made this thing even scarier somehow! And I'm for some reason gonna... You know what? This is not an effective way to damage it at all. Okay. So at some point we're gonna need to actually get on top of those pillars that keep popping up. And we are taking way more damage than we need to be taking right now. Is this it? Nope, it's not. And he's gonna just destroy that. I've also noticed one other thing, the Spider Mastermind in this is a lot more mobile than the one in Doom 1, which, duh, almost everything is more mobile than Doom, in the original Doom enemies. I mean, the imps, for God's sake, like, the biggest case of, we're gonna make an enemy that can, jump around and act like it's on, like it's got ADD and is on, like, a sugar binge, while also being on a cocaine binge? Because, you know, okay, maybe they may not be that jittery. And we're out of ammo here, so... Ah, crap! Really? Let me see if I can run over here. Chainsawing bosses will not work, as a reminder. There we go. And... I think direct shots to the face will actually deal more damage. And here we go. This is the part where we actually need to get up here because he's starting to electrify the floor. Actually, I think maybe the micro missiles might be better. No, they do not. Holy crap. That was pathetic. God's rifle? No, wrong one, wrong upgrade, wrong upgrade! No! Why did you do this? I wasted a shot! Okay, up, okay. That did a lot more damage to me than I thought it would ever do. What in the world? Not sure what we're doing here at this point. I'm panicking. Not sure if I actually need to. Okay, so, ow. Stop shocking the floor! Shouldn't be this powerful. Ah, that spikes up the... That is new. I did not see him do that before. That is new. He's got some sort of armor against bullets at the bottom up here. Okay. Okay, what can we use here? Oh, we got some rockets. Ah, that hurts. Okay. Whew. And you're gonna send the spikes up. Yeah, this is actually a pretty tough boss fight, even on the easy mode. We've already expended all of our ammo. And I just now realize you can actually see the spike holes on these things. In all honesty, he's not that... I mean, he's harder than the other bosses because he just got... He's more of a damage sponge than, say, the Guardians or the Cyber Demon. But, yeah, this is... This, we're gonna, like... Chipping damage. Did we seriously just take damage for like 2 seconds? Like after his attack was done? There, okay. Phew. Getting close to the end. And you got a full stock of ammo, it looks. So, I'll go ahead and just rip him. He's got psychic powers! They gave the Spider Mastermind psychic powers! And we've beaten him! There's one more. Do we get the kill? Come on. There we go. We get to put in an unloaded BFG into him and just blow his brains out. And we got the last of the figures. And our tether is activated. So yeah, we successfully defeated the Spider Mastermind and Olivia Pierce. By the way, that was not Olivia Pierce. If you read the bios for the Spider Mastermind, it is its own demon. And it kind of absorbed Olivia and...
You've won. It's over. You stopped the invasion and closed the portal. But it's come at a price. Argent.
I'm not gonna say anything. This entire operation. Actually, I got Vega right here in this USB drive. To work.
Come to understand your motivation. You think the only way is to kill them all, leave nothing behind. And you may be right. But we can't just shut it all down. Without Argent energy, it will be worse. I don't expect you to agree.
And he took the crucible from us.
With this, we can continue our work. I am not the villain in this story. I do what I do because there is no choice.
Rerouting tether coordinates complete.
Our time is up. I can't kill you, but I won't have you standing.
That is awesome! Why couldn't we have used that against the Spider Mastermind? That would have been so freaking cool. But how... That does lead to the question. How did Samuel Hayden know that was a sword? And so yeah, that's the end of Doom. Can't wait for the sequel, because Lord knows it's not explained any of the DLC. Seriously, there's no single-player DLC for this game, except for arcade mode. Which is just, hey, you want to go through the levels even faster? Yeah, that's basically it. But here we get some cool vignettes of Doom Slayer slaying some Doom. slaying some demons. Including a very cool vignette of the Cyber Demon. I forgot that was there. That's actually pretty cool. Yeah, this is like really cool. Oh, this is like this is a good way to end your game. Like, just put like very cool scenery porn for everyone to kind of view. And now the ending. Now that I've seen on my game one file makes sense. For those of you that actually bothered to actually pause and look at it, which hopefully would be only the people who've beaten the game. Even then, if you haven't beaten the game, you couldn't really tell it's the Spider Mastermind. But would you expect anything else? We've already fought the Cyber Demon. The Icon of Sin is even then not really a well-known boss in Doom 2. It's kind of one of the worst. Kind of like just there to put an ending, I guess. Really, it's the Cyber Demon that you care about, and the Spider Mastermind, and oh boy, I just had a thought, that was a horrible thought. So in Doom, and I believe both Doom and Doom 2, there are at least some points where you actually have to fight both the Spider Mastermind and the Cyber Demon. Can you imagine having to fight both of them at the same time? In this game, gah. It'd be a cluster bomb of death. It'd be chaos on the battlefield. I kind of want to see how that would work. Especially if you put in, like, them as they are now. Like, how would you do that? At some point, I'd imagine they'd have to start fighting each other, because that's the only way to be able to make it balanced. And also, you know, one would be interrupting the other's attacks. Like, say, when the Cyber Demon does that that canyon attack, the thing where he just launches the two walls around you, most people won't think to jump out. Like, I just started doing that on this playthrough. This is my third time fighting the Cyber Demon. So most people would be trapped in there. Then the Spider Demon would just launch in, just break through the walls, trying to get to you, giving you a way out. Presumably, we'd have to assume, depending on the arena, the Spider Mastermind wouldn't be able to electroshock the floors, unless there's blood on the floors, like in the arena. But, I don't know. Who knows? Whoa! What the? Did not mean to do that. As you can probably hear, I'm moving stuff around, and one thing moved onto my keyboard, so yeah, that hit the tilde key. One thing I want to mention. Apparently, using cheat codes in this game, in the single player game, will lock you out of Snap Map in multiplayer, which is really weird, because they're technically kind of their own game. Because in order to get into them, you have to reload the entire game from scratch. You'll notice once we get done with the credits, I'll show you what I mean. You'll notice that when we get to the end. You'll see those like campaign, Snap Map, and multiplayer. Clicking on campaign will obviously open up the campaign, as you noticed, the few times that we've done it. But if you go to Snap Map, it'll say, launch Snap Map. It'll ask you if you're sure you want to launch into Snap Map. And then, hit yes, it closes out Doom and relaunches its Snap Map mode, which is really weird because there's not really a way to open Snap Map any other way, so it's really weird. Same with multiplayer. It does the same thing with multiplayer, and like there's no way to open up multiplayer separately, outside of launching the main game, which I guess would be considered a launcher. But it's really weird that they did that. But yeah, so I think I've been rambling on a lot. Well, I gotta ramble on here because we're in the credit scene. What the hell am I thinking? Clearly, if you've seen any of my dialogue, clearly I'm not thinking much because my brain is right now is like running at what feels like 15 miles a second. Guess that's what I get for drinking two glasses of tea before doing a Let's Play. I know it's not the most heavily caffeinated beverage out there, but my God. It's like the equivalent of drinking a cup of coffee. But yeah. Final thoughts on Doom. Really good game. Really, really good game. Can't describe enough how great of a game it actually is. Supposedly during the course of this game, there was a lot of stuff that was good, that was like, apparently when they hired the guy to do the music, I'm not sure who does the music, but when they hired the guy to do the music, they said, no metal. No heavy metal. Which, that kind of goes against Doom, doesn't it? Because Doom is heavy metal. Doom's soundtrack has always been heavy metal, except for the one time when, you know, Doom didn't do too well. You know, Doom 3. The one time when you tried not doing heavy metal and it sucked. Also known as Doom 3. The horrible version. Oh, God. Clearly, I am not Chugger Conroy, so my puns aren't nearly as good? Question mark? Like, how was he saying that? I was like, wait a minute. Is there even such a thing as a good pun? I mean, I guess so. I mean, I've seen good puns before. I mean, I've seen some very, oh my God, some very bad, very good puns. Very good bad puns, very good puns. But yeah, so. Good game, very good game. I love just about everything they put into this. I know it gets a lot of criticism, primarily towards the end of the game when it starts getting a little repetitive, I guess you could say. And yeah, the final Argent Nerd definitely shows when you have to do the same thing essentially three times in succession. But thankfully, it's not that bad. And it doesn't overstay its welcome. So it's not like, it's short, so it's not like it's too hatefully bad, you know? But yeah, so. This is definitely worth the money. I don't know what else to say. I can only. At least it's a lot better than what it could have been. And that, to me, is, like, one of the most important things about this, too. Like, they worked hard on making this game as good as they could possibly do. The people who worked on the game had to fight hard to get what they wanted because, I don't know, the publishers, whoever, publishers, executives upstairs are clearly nuts. That's my opinion on every producer, publisher, executive, almost every one of them. In Hollywood and in games too, especially, cause like, one of the worst things that you see happening on a day-to-day basis is just executives and publishers just butting heads with the developers. Cause the developers have a vision, but the executives and the publishers don't want that vision because it's not because they don't think it's gonna make the money, even though it would make the money. I don't even know how to describe my cynicism towards executives and the the corporate philosophy, I guess, the corporate structure that we've grown so dependent on. It's the main reason Young Justice failed on Cartoon Network, and why the Thundercats reboot never got a second season. And it's so, like, so many great things never got a second season because they couldn't make money off the merchandising. And of course they couldn't make money off the freaking merchandising. You never sold any merchandise. Like, with Thundercats. Thundercats is on, I think, had like maybe 14 episodes, I think, in its first season. Ended on a cliffhanger, so that kind of sucks that that happened. But, like, the important thing is it ended after its first season because it couldn't make any money off of merchandise. Which, my first thought was, wait a minute! I've never even seen any of the new Thundercats toys or anything like that. And this, you're talking about someone who, whenever he goes out to Target, always checks out the toy section to see what's new. Primarily Transformers and Legos, because, you know, that's my interest, but, and I've been eyeing the Voltron toys recently, because I kind of want to get the five lions that turn into Voltron. It's just, all that would be pretty expensive to buy at once, and I don't want to buy it piece by piece, because if you end up one off, because they end up running out of toys and you can't get a hold of them, then you don't have the whole collection, and that's gonna suck. I actually had that happen to me as a kid. I had exactly one of the Constructicons, and this was back in the day when the Constructicons you had to buy separately. For those that don't know, Constructicons are like evil Transformers. They're Decepticons. They're all construction vehicles that turn into one giant, that they each turn into their own machine and their own robot, but then they also transform into a giant robot. And it's awesome. Like, just look up Devastator, and just look up Transformers Devastator into Google, and it'll be like the first thing you'll see. You'll see like this neon green looking robot with, like, it looks like he's comprised like a forklift, a truck, a steam, a cement truck, a crane. I'm trying to think of all the other ones. The arm one with the big arm hook thing, the shovel. I can't remember what that is. A bulldozer. Is that what it is? A bulldozer? Maybe, I don't know. I can't remember the name of that, of all the vehicles. But yeah, it's like, it looks like it's built from various construction vehicles. And yeah, that's Devastator. Wow, these are some long credit scenes. I did not realize how long this would be. I think we're getting close to the end. I think we're on Zenimax. I think Zenimax is the last one. Whew. Trying to think here what else I can talk about. Can't wait for the sequel. Because you know this game is going to make a sequel. It's got way too much attention not to make a sequel, you know. It's gotta make a sequel, and we've gotta finish up the story. We've gotta figure out what's gonna happen with, like, how we're gonna deal with Samuel Hayden, how we're gonna get out of wherever we went to. Like, I don't even know where Doomslayer went. Like, was he tethered back into hell? Cause didn't we seal the portal off? So we can't go back in, right? But then, like, I don't know. Regardless, we have to find a way, they have to find a way to deal with Samuel Hayden, because now he's the new bad guy. Even though he sits there saying that he's not the villain. But yeah. I am out of things to say now. This is really long. These are really long credit scenes. Why are they so long? Yeah. Then you're having to do other things in the process here just because I'm trying to kill time on my end. But at the same time, I gotta come up with things to talk about. I don't know what I want to talk. I could talk about, like, you know, I could talk about the same stuff I always bitch and complain about, like, but I don't want to be that guy that's annoying with this stuff, with that stuff. And I know, like, the whole internet pretty much already knows about half the stuff, half the crap in the news. And, you know, gaming news also, like, there's been some crappy things going on the gaming side of things too. That's always gonna happen. So it's, I think we're at the end here. I think we're almost at the end. Legal acknowledgement, we're at the end. I think we're, yeah, okay. We're at the end, okay, we can get excited, guys, we're almost done with the credits. Unto the evil, hell followed, bloodfall. Are those? Oh, I think those are the DLC packs for multiplayer. Okay. I still don't know. I have not touched the multiplayer in this game at all. Unless you count Snap Map, which I did a few bits in it. Eh. It's okay. It's impressive what people can do with it, but it's also like, I look at it like, I wish it was so much more. Like, there's so much more they could have done with it. So many little things, too, that kind of keep it from being great. Yeah, the multiplayer is, like, the thing that, like, no, I don't think anyone plays the multiplayer for this game. Always, what? Hold up, what? Voice casting, directing, and recording by Womb Music. Okay. Well, are we still not done yet? Jeez, this is long. What the? Yes, they had a lot of quality assurance testers. QA testers, wow. They actually had game testers on this. They had a lot of people testing this. Oh my gosh. Ugh. Additional quality assurance. These are the guys that didn't have to pay. These are the guys that didn't have to pay to do the testing. That's why they're the additional. They looked over this guy while they were playing the game like, hey, Michael Lucia, this looks good, right? Yeah, it looks fine. Okay, now we're done. Now we're done, okay. Oh, this took so long. I think the credit scenes were longer than the actual game. Jeez, that was a long time. Okay, so yeah. We got one last thing to do. So yeah, now we see we got two game. Got our collectibles. We got the last two guys. We got the chain gun, which we have the, quick spin, and then we hit R to see the actual Gatling mod, which, again, it's kind of a shame you don't get to see it opened up, it activated. So I'd like to see it from, like, all angles to see how it looks, because looking at it from the back, you only see the two barrels, the third one you won't get to see very much of. But yeah. And then we have the Spider Mastermind. Ooh. Give that thing a plasma gun. And suddenly you made the most overpowered thing in the world. And especially when it has like these side beam lancers. I think that's what the technical term is. And this fire straight out beam like that. I could be completely wrong, but I've always heard them called lancers. Because it's kind of like very similar to a lance and like it's straight beam shot thing. I don't know. Or maybe the term comes from like lancing a boil. But yeah, so, that's it for the game. So, I will see you guys in the next Let's Play.